Evening, folks, this is Best in Slot. We're back with a little bit more Planet Zoo franchise mode. We're working on My Pen Rai. We currently have four animals in the zoo now. We've got our giant forest scorpion living in here, very popular, as you can see. We have our many, many thousands upon thousands of flamingos, again, as you can kind of see. They keep kind of breeding. I think I've gone from like 10 to 30 or something like that. Also, random little bug, research completes whilst you're paused. I don't know what rate, but it's happened so many times now that I'm 100% sure that's happening. So yeah, many flamingos. Remember, we had 10 at the start, so yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, at least. Really cool little thing happened. I didn't get it on video, unfortunately. The flamingos never come down here, really. But at one point, oh, I do need a caretaker. At one point, somebody over here threw a hamburger into the lake. Like, they littered the hamburger. And one of my flamingos darted across the entire lake, just ran all the way across, ate the burger, and then ran all the way back. As you can see, I've got tons of CC. I've been busy working in my breeding zoo. I bred many, many tigers. Now, this is the last thing I want to talk about before we get the time-lapse going. At the moment, there's a community challenge to breed. I think it's 250,000 Bengal tigers, something like that, I can't remember. Around about 72%. And I decided to get involved, right? And basically, as you breed more and more tigers, you get more and more rewards. So if we hop over here and into the community challenge bit, you'll see we're on 75,000 we're looking for. I've bred 49 Bengal tigers, and that was enough to get me to the top tier. So you get more rewards, basically how many tigers you've bred relative to the entire community. So this is like if you bred one tiger, and I think it took 40 to get to the top tier. Now, I thought I'd save the rewards. I have no idea what this includes. I've never seen this before. This is our first community challenge. I'm really excited. Let's find out what we're gonna get. Oh. Okay, what did we get? I got a tiger outfit! That's amazing! Oh my god, I got a full-on tiger out. I got shorts, a t-shirt, and a hat. I love that. I got 1,000 CC, which would have been really good, but I don't really need it. I got a Japanese macaw, I got a Galapagos giant tortoise, and I got a Western gorilla. So let's have a little look at those. That should be in our animal trading and rewards. They are incredibly mediocre, unfortunately. Actually, the Western Lowland's pretty good. Good stats there, other than the immunity gene. The others are, unfortunately, nothing particularly special. I'm going to release those to the wild. That's a bit of a shame. But we got a new outfit, and I've got so much CC. So, you know, when we buy Komodo dragons and stuff, we're going to get top-of-the-line fancy Komodo dragons. Now, I need to go plan what the hell this exhibit is going to look like. I think we're going to use this a little bit. We're going to make some coves and stuff like that, give them some shrouded, hidden areas, get some forest in there, get some beach in there. And then this is going to lead on to the water. I don't really know how I'm going to tie all this together quite yet, but I will go have a think. Let's get started. Right, time-lapse time. I did eventually come up with a little bit of an idea for this Komodo dragon exhibit. I promised to do no more chasms, but it is kind of the story of this entire park. This entire area has been ripped apart by this natural catastrophe, and I like having it impact various exhibits in various ways. This will, I promise, I nearly promise, be the last time I bring it up, and definitely the last time we work with a chasm, but I will say I'm putting it in here mainly mainly as a decoration, not really connected to the actual exhibit itself that much. My actual idea for the exhibit, I didn't really have much in the way of... It's probably our most zoo-like exhibit by the end, our most regular-looking exhibit. There's like a fence, and you can see the fence. It's like the first exhibit that's actually happened. I'm not sure what the in-world justification for that is, other than, well, yeah, at the end of the day, we said that they wanted to... That was a penis. They wanted to contain and look at these animals. I feel like I say that every episode. So my gimmick, the only thing I really had for this video, was I really liked the idea of crossing over the pit, over the chasm, and then going down into a dark tunnel and appearing underneath the Komodo dragon exhibit. Well, actually, the Komodo dragon exhibit itself is going to be a double-layered exhibit. Because they're, you know, large lizards and they're in this very warm, sunny environment, I wanted them to have somewhere they could go to hide and to escape from the sun, which is something we all want to do, let's be honest. So the idea is you're going to cross over the chasm and down into this little area beneath, you know, this area on the left, and in there the Komodo dragons are going to bask. I mean, they're going to hide away from the sun. They're going to do the opposite of basking, actually. They're going to Kassab. They're going to Kassab in there so you can watch them from that side, or indeed you can watch them from above whilst I'm wandering around in the sandy bit. I haven't added the Komodos yet, of course, that's something we always do together at the end of the video. I don't know how much sand they can stomach. I like how the sand looks. I think it makes this whole exhibit and area feel just a little bit different, and it is going to lead on to not an ocean, but a large lake area, and I think it looks quite cool having the sand around there. Oh, for reference, this was a 2-hour build, something like that, so we are recording this on about 6x the speed for the time lapse. That's my happy spot, because you can actually see what's going on. When the builds take like 3 hours, like say the Tiger one did, then I have to slow down even more. But here we go, just making a little viewing area down here. We're going to bring the walls in at some point, just making it nice and symmetrical. And again, this kind of makes sense, right? Let's say this is where they would go to get away from the sun, but it's probably also where they would nest. It's like a safe area away from prying eyes. They can hide the babies on the ground, stuff like that. It makes sense that this is the kind of area that we would, as, you know, conservationists, people living in this area, in this national park, it's the kind of place they would want to observe. What I'm trying to do here is just make the whole, the sort of little tunnel pathway down into the earth. So I actually want zookeepers to be able to go down here. I want them to be able to visit down in that lower location, and of course the Komodos themselves need to be able to do it. So it's really important that this is a really nice smooth ramp, and it ends up looking pretty good. It's not a million miles away, and it has this kind of secret little cove feeling to it, which I really, really like. I say this isn't that interesting, but I don't think that's ever actually something I've done before. You know, an area we can walk underneath and the animal itself has like a double layered exhibit. I'm sure lots of people have, but I think it's new for me. Let's have to block this off a little bit. There's a lot of terrain playing in this video. Really, that's 90% of what we're doing. Again, there's not much in the way of... I think there's not much, there's zero in the way of fancy building work. The bridge and that little tunnel that I've already made, and the barrier requires a little bit of finagling, is the extent of it. Everything else is terrain and foliage and stuff like that, and kind of a bit of tapping out and planning for the future and stuff like that as well. The barrier is a problem because of how, because you've got that underground space, you'll see what the issue is here. The viewing area goes further than where I would want the top of the Komodo dragon exhibit to be, and because it's lower down, what you have to do is go down, put the barrier there first at that lower level, then bring it right up to the top and then add your next barrier, and that's the only way to effectively do that, I believe. So I'm just going to connect all that up. It is going to be glass for now, but it won't be at the end. But glass is curvy, and we love them curvy. I'm still not sure what I'm doing for it. I think I'm going to use the chainmail. Not chainmail, it's not a bloody... It's not the medieval times Komodo dragon. Although that would be cool. I think what I want to use is the one-way glass down in the... You know, in the area down there. We're going to put some lights in, and we'll put some one-way glass in down in the observation chamber bit, but I don't have it unlocked yet. We're very close, but not quite yet. Just checking to make sure the Komodo dragon's not going to jump out like every other animal. We're going to cover it up a little bit. There's a lot of this... Again, this is based on what the environment actually looks like sometimes, especially when it's in the water, but I've sort of expanded it a little bit. But there's a lot of these mountains, a lot of these slightly flat-topped, curvy, pointed forward mountains dotted around the landscape, and it's a good way to obscure certain parts of the park, and it's a good way to obscure buildings, and a good way to obscure the path, and stuff like that. And once this is done, folks, two animals left in this park. We're actually nearly done. Temporarily. So the next two animals are going to be, I keep forgetting which crocodile, it's either the gharial or the saltwater. Whichever one doesn't go in here is going to go in the other park, in the temperate one. And the Indian elephant, which is what we're going to do in the next video. See, this is me checking. I'm not happy with the barrier looking like that, but I can't find one that I like. Unfortunately, I was going to say there's no way we can do it so that downstairs is a short barrier. But if we cover the top area exactly around where the barrier would be, if we cover that with terrain, which I kind of do, but I don't entirely do, if we cover that with terrain, then we can sink the barrier downstairs lower down and still have a Komodo dragon that can't escape. We might have to think about doing that, actually. As per usual, cover everything in stone. It's easier to cover it in stone and then attack it with the sand brush and then attack it with the grass. I did decide I went too hard on the sand, so I'm going to be bringing in a lot of grass and a lot of foliage. At the end of the day, this area is meant to be... because there's always a reason. I mean, of course, the Earthquake has kind of split this world up a little bit. This is where it hit the hardest. You know, you can see this big chasm, and it's a double-sided one with the path in the middle. And where the tectonic plates have shifted upwards, it's of course caused this earth to sprout up. You know, that's what happens with islands and stuff like that. You know, the tectonic plates push land masses upwards. So whilst this was, you know, the forest on the right, and we've got the lake behind us, by pushing up the area, by splitting it with the chasms, and by splitting it with these emerging land masses, it's created like the opposite of an oasis, essentially, wherein everywhere else is had this water access, this place doesn't, and the mountains and stuff like that have kind of created this hidden little cove, which is somewhat protected by rainfall. There's a couple little pools that are gonna, we need to, the bridge was unsupported, it needs love. There's gonna be a couple little pools in there, just because it was a very tropical environment and there should be more hints to that, but generally speaking, that's kind of the in-universe reason I'm going with for why this place looks the way it does. Just because, you know, there's something catastrophic went on, right? This big change, and that's gonna have an effect in terms of the wildlife, and it's gonna have a big effect in terms of the kind of environment. I have no idea what I do for the next like 12 minutes. I'm not even halfway through this time lapse. Gotta do this to make that look a little less daft. Need to cover all that with trees. We'll get there eventually. There's a lot of planning here, a lot of thinking about the future, where we're gonna put the Indian elephant exhibit, for example. Ah, yes, the fences. Trying so hard to get it to automatically stand up. It's not gonna happen. I have to do it myself. You always have to do it your blooming self, folks. Never send a fence to do a YouTuber's job. That's what I always say. That's what I'm saying. So we're just going to put those along. Again, like I said, this is probably one of the more zooey builds in the entire thing. We've got an area with a fence, which is already more zooey. There's going to be donation boxes. There's going to be information things. Top tip, by the way, if you hit L, it puts a little lamp on, like you see here. That's coming from our camera. So yeah, there's going to be that. There's going to be what looks like an actual viewing area that you can see the fence and walk past. It does look somewhat zooey. Somewhat national parky, let's say it like that. It's still a very nice, wide, open area for the Komodos to live in. You know, somewhere they'd really like and enjoy. Hopefully, I don't know, we haven't added them yet. We're going to add them later on. You know, when I do these time-lapse voiceovers, I haven't done. Well, sometimes I've done the last bit, sometimes I haven't. Right now, I haven't. I haven't added the Komodo dragons to the zoo, so I don't actually currently know how it's going to go. Usually I can tell you guys with a little bit of a sneak peek. Now, I don't know, disaster may be waiting for me in about 10 minutes, which is when I'm going to record it, so pray for me, folks. Pray for me. Anyways, yeah, just finish off the railing, make the log cool. Only want a cool log. Do need to cover this with wood. I haven't actually done that yet, but just generally speaking, making it tie in a little bit more aesthetically with the rest. But you can see just that little glimpse of where I put those donation boxes. By what I mean, oh god, underground building is such a pain. You can see what I mean. It is a large area with, at the end of the day, just a fence. You know, I have to start sticking in some staff buildings. We're gonna do what we always do and hire some staff that live in this area. I think I'm realizing that I never, ever, ever going to make money in this park. I think the layout is so extravagantly large that there's not really any way to do it. On the plus side, you will be able to see the animals really well from here. That's just a future path there. I didn't want to have that in, but I kind of want to be able to plan around. So eventually we're going to go that way for our crocodiles. The Indian elephant is going to be behind the tiger exhibit. Actually behind the orangutan exhibit. It's cool though, we're gonna have tons of room to play with. So again, to refresh your memories as we try to put this solar panel in, it was necessary, but I figured we can at least try to make it blend in a little bit. Now, interestingly enough, you do actually have to give the solar panel some solar energy. You can't actually put a roof on it or it doesn't work. So I will at some point end up making a little hole in the roof. So we just, there's a lot of this, a lot of just making the world look a little bit mountainous and craggy and stuff like that. Again, it's been hit by this huge impact. It's kind of how it should feel. It should have a whole new environment, but with bits of the past environment still popping up. A lot of the plant life has died and stuff like that, but some has survived for sure, and you're going to see a lot of that. Plus, the forest itself has begun to spread in this direction. You know, the forest is a hardy son of a bitch. It's going to start moving over here. What's I about to talk about? I had something to talk about. I've completely forgotten. Fantastic. Oh, yes, the elephant. No. So to remind people what I'm doing, I have made a Word document with every single animal in Planet Zoo, and they've all been divided into 8 or 9 zoos, something like that. That includes African zoos that have like 20 animals each. I think African Tropical and African Grassland both have about 20 animals, just because half the animals in the game, literally half the animals in the game, literally over half the animals in the game are African. I think about 3/5 of animals in the game are African. So they've got 2 big African zoos. There's also an African Desert Zoo, which is a lot smaller. And then 3 Asian zoos. This one, a temperate one, and a tiger one. Taija. People keep yelling at me about Taija. There's also a European one, which has nothing in it. There's a North American one, which is very small. There's a South American one, which is fine, full of animals, but most of them are exhibit animals. And there's also an Oceania one. You know, we're doing basically every single animal in the game, every single continent in the game is going to have at least one zoo. And the idea is we can theme all these differently. You know, some of them are going to be very open national parks like this. Everyone's going to have a theme or an idea behind it. Some of them are going to be much more zoo-like at the end of the day. Some of them are going to look like zoos, hopefully, kind of like our beta zoo. And the idea is we're going to build all these zoos until we've got every single animal in the game in a zoo. We will own, in our franchise mode, because this is, of course, a franchise mode with several zoos under one banner, searching for sloths. I'll have to hop back to the main page and show you that eventually. Eventually, we'll have every single zoo contained within our franchise, and then we're going to build the Mega Zoo. And the Mega Zoo is going to be more like what we did during the beta. It's just going to be one big-ass zoo with various sections dedicated to various areas of the continent or various biomes, stuff like that. So we can have a reptile house, we can have an Africa zone, we can do whatever the hell we want. And the idea, I may as well talk about this whilst you're going to watch me put foliage everywhere. It looks better already though, foliage helps. The rocks will help a lot more, but the foliage was a good start. I really wanted to get the feeling of, there should still be foliage there, there should be foliage that's pressing through the dust. This idea a little bit like the natural forest that was there is still there, just lurking underneath a little bit, you know, obscured by this new material. What was I saying? Exciting words, I bet. Yeah, so there has to be some foliage, but I did want to limit myself a little bit, just because it is meant to be a much more arid environment in general. It's meant to feel different than the rest of it, but if it's too sandy and it's too lacking in foliage, it kind of sticks out badly rather than in a good way. It should feel different it should feel different while still feeling like it's part of this world, you know? So it's rock time. There's going to be a lot of rock time. That's what I do for the rest of the video, rocks. Anyways, so the idea is we'll eventually build a master zoo. With every single animal in the game. And every one of those animals, this is my hope, I'm not sure whether I'm going to commit to this, but that's a rough idea. The hope is that every animal in the master zoo, because in franchise you can trade animals between zoos, you just send them to the trade center, and then when you load another zoo in, that zoo will be there. So the plan is to have a master zoo wherein all the animals in the master zoo are sent to us by the other zoos that I have, right? So let's say I wanted an orangutan in my master zoo, I'd come here, wait for my baby orangutan to grow up, and then send it over to the master zoo, whatever that's going to be called. It'll be European based, I'm sure, just because I'm European for now. So that's the idea, right? To kind of like fund this big multicultural world spanning zoo with the animals from our other zoos, because those zoos do take place all across the planet. I think it's a really nice thought, and it'll also mean we maybe get a little bit more attached to the animals than we typically do, because they're going to transfer zoos and stuff like that. Yeah, I'm quite excited about that as a plan. The other thing we're going to do is, because there's going to be plenty of room left in these zoos, like this one for example, we've only got 2 animals left to go, we're going to have room for probably 8 or 9 more. If I'm pessimistic, I actually thought I was going to run out of room, but we've got tons and tons of room left. So if a DLC comes out and it adds more Asian tropical animals to the game, we can just add another exhibit to this zoo. And I've got an idea that I really like of doing it like a real zoo, you know, where they've got a little area like that says like coming soon and what animals are coming soon, and there's like a little closed off section of the park. When we come back to an old park, because this park will be essentially finished, right? It'll be ready for guests, it'll be done, every animal that we want in it will be done, and it'll probably be like that for say a couple of months. But then when the new animal gets added, we can come back to it, we can close off a bit, we can have like a staff section, we can have like a hazard line and all this stuff, and we can build our new animal exhibit and then have like a grand opening. It can become an event, and we'll have a zoo ready for every single animal in the game when it gets added. That's the plan anyway. So this is at minimum a I'd say, like, let's assume some exhibit animals can be done in multiple episodes in South America and stuff like that. This is probably a 70-episode series, at least, before you get to the main zoo, which then adds another 70. So this is going to be a longer series, but that's totally fine by me, and hopefully with a lot of you folks as well. I know I said that this was like a little sandy oasis, but then I had to put an oasis in my oasis. Okay, I like Oasisception. I should talk about the build. It is just having rocks and foliage. You guys have seen me do this plenty of times. And I know I have to prattle on throughout the entire video. But the rocks really do make a difference. Rocks and foliage put in well do make all the difference in the world. And I will say, like, people have a go sometimes because I'm a little, not hard on myself for my building skills, but I acknowledge that maybe building buildings is not my strong suit. But this is my strong suit. This is the bit I'm good at, in my opinion. So it's always fun for me to get involved and get to... Okay, this bit looks boring in a way, but it's just because it's rocks. It's always fun to chuck in some rocks and foliage. It's when your exhibit really comes to life. And it lets you hide all manner of sins. It really does. A good rock and a good foliage placement can really change up how something looks. Also, new obsession. Coastal mangroves sunk into the ground. I know the sunk into the ground thing I do all the time anyway, and everyone's been doing for a long time. But... they look really good sunk into the ground. It's like this really light, airy little bush, and it looks great, and I kind of became obsessed with it, to be honest. So, need some signposts. I'll see these aren't on yet, but they will eventually see Komodo Dragon. So I just start doing... Yeah, that's where we do it. Stick the speakers on the back of the sign. I can't remember who I saw do that, but yeah, it's a good idea. Because the speakers are weird. They just float randomly otherwise, and then you put them on the ground, but then it looks like someone's just left the speaker on the ground and somebody would break it. If you hide it behind the speakers, behind the signs, who's going to break it? Because they won't know. It's like when you climb up behind the cinema screen. Taking some screenshots. It's not the most... Oh, I do actually do this. It's not the most visually unique exhibit. It basically just looks like a big, normally built exhibit. I mean, it looks nice, but it doesn't have, like, as big of a hook. And the orangutan had the chasm, and it had the story about the guy, and it had this huge waterfall feature. The tiger, of course, has the chasm. It's a huge lake. It's got a temple. The flamingos had this abandoned village. Even the scorpion lives in the village. Lives in the village. Whereas this guy's is just a nice big exhibit, basically. It is, like I say, our most zoo-y one yet. I mean, even can put signs on. This is what I'm trying to do right here. Find an appropriate rock for signage. That's the one I like. I believe we call it Komodo Cove. I really wanted to spell cove with a K, but I hate that. It hurts my soul when people do that, so I resisted. A couple of signs lying around all over the place, just pointing out where our animals are going to be. At the end of the day, this, you know, it's meant to be a place where people can come and see animals. We need to tell them where they are. So tigers, orangutans, flamingos. A little bit more foliage, of course. Hey, shut up. How dare you be driving around in the middle of the day? Shameful behaviour. Shameful. The cove, the village, the forest. Yeah. It should be a K. It's a zoo. You know, a zoo would have a K cove. It just would. It's what they all bloody do. So, again, more signage. Orangutans, tigers, Komodo dragons. And eventually, elephants and crocodiles of some description. I keep forgetting. It's either gharials or saltwater. They were actually both going to be in the zoo. But somebody suggested that we move the Indian elephants in just because... And I like the idea. I think the Indian elephants are going to look really cool in the jungle. So I did swap them around. And it means I've forgotten which one is which. So that is the end of the time lapse. Like I said, nothing hugely unique. You're going to see a better up close now anyway. You know, obviously we'll take our time a little bit more. We do have the underground viewing area. We do have... Well, that's about it. So, let's hop into the end of the video. Basically, we're going to go add the Komodo Dragons to our game for the first time. As you can see, I am loaded with CC still. Right, see you in a sec. Right, it's Komodo Dragon time. Just realized I have no money whatsoever, however. That's fine, I have a... Oh my god, never mind. Komodo Dragon, right, this is not acceptable. We're going for gold, obviously. Why not? Can we get some... Ah, look at that beautiful price. Okay, who's young? You're young and surprisingly unfertile. That's a good one. Let's grab that one. It's really nice having enough CC that I can just kind of do what I want, you know? That's really good. Only 7.9. Let's grab that. Sweet. Okay. Actually, tell you what. We might grab a few more. The more animals we can get, the better. The problem with the tigers is we can only have two tigers. The more animals we can get, the more chance the guests will actually be able to see an animal, which would be the first time that's ever happened in my zoo, so... Oh, for God's sake, every animal in the bloody game... Every bloody animal in the game is 1 to 2, I swear. Stupid animals. Be more social. Move. And move. Move. There we go. I'm sorry, buddy. You'll be fine. Right. Our new Komodos are here. One of my favourite all-time animals, the Komodo dragons. I'm really excited about this. There's Ratu, our female, and our male Bascoro. I tell you what, welfare 92%. I haven't done a bloody thing. That's pretty great. Oh, no. Oh, no. Everything's terrible. Flamingo Lake is breaking. Let's get a mechanic. There should be a mechanic. Yeah, there he is. He literally lives here, so that should be fine. One thing you should do, I'm surprised this has happened, but I thought I already did this, is you can change how often the mechanic maintenance is. It's every 3 months, and it's still broken. Oh, and perfect timing. Let's get that on the go. Let's get that on the go. Otis. Otis is my man. It's a good leg. Good leg? It's going to go for good lad and good egg at the same time. He's a good leg. Now, I'm not totally convinced the keeper's going to be able to handle all this, so let's have a little look at that. I once again have no money, but that's kind of becoming the norm at this point in time. That's okay. Who needs money to run a zoo? Nobody, that zoo. Nerds. I know you're hungry, buddy. Where are you? Have you not eaten? Where's the feeder? Come back, come over here. Right, there's food in here. Although the keeper needs to hurry up and get here. What are you doing? I really wish... Oh my god, that didn't take long. Oh yeah, I forgot to check this. Okay, that should have been my first thing I did. Right. How did they get in and out? So let's... I'm going to need some more money. Let's click our Komodo dragon. And let's click habitat. Ah! Oh, so it's such a tiny little mistake as well. Nearly perfect. There we go. Oh, yeah, I have no money. We should be good then. That should be enough. And I'm going to do a... I'm just going to do an emergency capture here, I think. Yeah, there we go. He's going to go make some food. Sweet. Dangerous animal escaped. No, she's fine. Right, so we need to get a partner for our Bengal tigers once more. But we'll do that. I'll do that later. It's fine. This is messy. This is super messy. Oh, Arnav, I'm sorry. Oh, he died and he went into the temple to die. He just died in front of everyone. Arnav, what are you doing? He's trying to ruin my park at the last second. People are not loving it. Bascoro, where are you? Oh, he's over here. Ah, he went for a dip. He's on the move. Bascoro is on the move. Oh, come on, Bascoro. Look how lovely the pit looks, yes. Bascoro, no, he's decided against it. Where's your partner? Go put a baby in her. At least when you have babies, it's technically two more animals than two. Bascoro's having a little nap. Oh. Rara's running past, she's on the sprint, dodges Bascoro, heads off into the wilds. If they walk past now, they'll see a sleeping Komodo dragon. That's good, that's cool. We've got a little cool in the grand viewing area, which in reality is pretty useless, but it's cool, and that's all that matters, in my opinion. Right, okay folks. Yeah, this is never going to be profitable. It's fine, I don't mind. It's a franchise. This is a failing zoo. I will prop it up with my other zoo. That makes a lot of sense to me. That is... a sufficient in-world universe excuse for me. And I really like this exhibit. I really think it blends in really well, despite the whole new terrains and stuff like that. People are here, people are loving it, maybe, possibly, yes. Not awful. Until then, thank you very much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Hit the like button if you enjoyed this build, and indeed, my pen Rai, our zoo in general so far. I will say, I've not lost lots of money over the last 5 minutes, so... We're getting there, folks. We're getting there. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much, as always. Bye-bye. Hey, folks. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way. I'll see you next time.